Hey, what's up, guys? It is Tuesday, the 6th of April, and all day today I've been working on my Unpluggin HIV outreach. That is part of my HIV outreach to people who are either homeless, low income, or actually in housing, still low income, and battling HIV and AIDS. And the biggest part of this outreach is for 40 residents down on Skid Row in downtown Los Angeles. And what I do through this outreach is I provide meals, I provide gently used clothing, I've provided televisions, gently used televisions, CD players, all a variety of things that the residents can request. And if I actually get it in the form of a donation, then I make it available to the person who was actually asked for it. Or if someone specifically asks for something, I'll either blog it on my blog or vlog it here on YouTube and see if anybody will respond to the need and get those items to them. Over the weekend, my Aunt Emma came by and she dropped off the Easter baskets for the Easter basket outreach. And she also dropped off clothes for women. And usually those clothes go to Judy because her and Aunt Emma are the same size. Well, this time there's a lot of clothes, so I'll be able to spread these clothes out to two different HIV outreaches. The first will be for Judy, and then the second will be down at Common Ground in Santa Monica. So it's really, really cool to get enough clothes that I could spread them out between two of the organizations that I support. The biggest thing for me is my outreach on the 21st, my Unplugging HIV outreach on the 21st. Is down on Skid Row, and I've been working really, really hard to come up with Understanding Your Labs presentation. It's been a year since I created this outreach, and it's been really, really hard finding resources. Well, it hasn't been hard finding the resources. It's been hard getting people to come down and speak on Skid Row. Primarily because I'm not a nonprofit. There's no way for me to pay people. And ASOs and other organizations, ASO is an AIDS service organization. For example, AIDS Project Los Angeles, Aid for AIDS, AIDS Service Center here in Los Angeles County. Those are AIDS service organizations. And then there's the Gay and Lesbian Center. So I've approached all these organizations several times, even tried to schedule things. And there's always a reason why they can't. There's just always a reason why they can't. So it's been a year of trying, a year trying, and a year trying. And thanks to Nick at my HIV clinic, he's the administrator at my HIV clinic. I just called him up, I gave him a call, told him what I was trying to do, and he put me in touch with somebody that I already know, but just didn't think to ask her. So she is actually going to do a presentation, and I'm calling it HIV Knowledge and Power because she's going to cover a variety of things. And then there's the possibility of her coming back in a couple of months and doing another presentation. So it's kind of cool to be able to do, actually it's very cool to be able to do this collaborative effort with her to bring information, empowerment, and services to people who are hardest hit by HIV and AIDS. And for me, it is just so, it's so phenomenal to be able to present this. And the cool thing is, you guys know, I spend my money getting the meals and things for this outreach. My friends help out when they can, but usually it's my money, and I don't have a lot of money to spend. So usually I have to save up for these outreaches in order to provide the meal. And this time around, the lady who's doing the presentation is going to provide the meal. So that takes so much pressure off of me. I'm still trying to get hygiene items and stuff like that for this outreach. There are 40 residents there. 3 of them are women. So trying to get like shampoos, conditioners, and things like that. One of my subscribers, Mocha, already sent a box of like a mango. It's a body wash. She already sent those. Those are travel size, so I'm going to use those for the outreach for people with HIV and AIDS who are actually homeless. These people are actually housed, so I do the full size shampoo, conditioners, and things like that for them. So still working on that. Still working on getting information on Hep A, B, and C. And hopefully be able to line up a nurse. I have a nurse in mind that I would like to have come down and do a presentation on Hep A, B, and C vaccinations and how very, very important it is for people who are or positive for Hep C, how very important it is for them to make sure they are staying adherent to their treatment guidelines. So that's what I've been working on today, and it's so cool to know that the presentation is taken care of, and it's so cool to be able to have a little bit of breathing room and work on some different things for the actual presentation. Since this is the year creation of the organization, there are some awards that I'm going to give out. I was hoping that I would be able to finish the ceramic bowls that I made and possibly present like a gift basket, but that doesn't look like it's going to happen. Ceramics was closed this past weekend, and next week, I'm just so busy coming up with this outreach and then leaving for AIDS Watch, I don't think that I'm going to be able to get the basket, the bowl that I created, completed in enough time to present it, which is sad, but I'll come up with something else. If I gotta buy a gift basket, a basket, and create a gift basket myself, then that's what I'll do. But I definitely want to present a basket to two people who, in my eyes, are just phenomenal at helping and assisting and navigating people through HIV and AIDS, as well as someone with HIV who has just been phenomenal at staying adherent to their drug regimen and things like that, and is just a powerful inspiration as well as role model to people with HIV and AIDS. I wanted to create two awards which are in honor of my cousin Theodore, Teddy is what we called him, who died due to complications from AIDS when I was younger, and then another award for a longtime family friend, Dennis, who died from complications due to AIDS when I was pretty young. In fact, that was my first encounter, my first face-to-face encounter with AIDS and what it looked like. And it was during the early stages of the diseases. And I just remember walking into his room and seeing him and just being so so afraid of what I saw, and then thinking, oh my God, that's gonna happen to me. That's going to be my reality. And thankfully, it's not my reality. And thankfully, I now have a doctor and a care team where it doesn't have to be my reality either. So those are the two awards that I wanted to give out. And that's why I was creating these bowls in ceramics, because I had hoped to have them finished in enough time to be able to do this, so I'll just have to come up with something else to present to people. So that's what I'm working on. The biggest thing is that I've nailed down the biggest part of my outreach for April. And I'm so happy about that. So very, very happy about that. So once again, that outreach takes place on the 21st of this month. If you'd like to get involved with that, you can go to www.dosomethingsaturday.org and click on the donate button if you choose to donate to that. And let me just say, if you choose to donate to my organization, please know that my organization is not a nonprofit. It is not a nonprofit, and it says that on the website. I just want to be upfront and clear with that. So peace and blessings, everybody. I hope you're having a great Tuesday.